Each iPhone update has added great new improvements and capabilities. And with iTunes, it's easy to download and install new software whenever an update becomes available. With the January 2008 software update, users will be able to customize their home screens, send SMS text messages to multiple people, find their location in maps, and more. Maps is one of the most helpful applications on iPhone, and we've made it even better with some great new features and enhancements. One of the best new features is the ability to find your location automatically using information from nearby Wi-Fi base stations or cell towers. The new Maps interface is both simpler and easier to use. In the lower left is the new location button. This button curls back the Maps page, giving you access to other great Maps features such as drop pin, display real-time traffic conditions, and select other map views. Tap the location button, and in seconds, iPhone triangulates your position and displays a circle with your location at its center. The better the accuracy of the location information, the smaller the area inside the circle. With this new feature, it's even easier to get directions to local points of interest or addresses. Perhaps you need directions to the airport. Tap Directions. Notice that your current location is preloaded in the start field. Now type the airport code as your endpoint, then just tap Route to get your directions. Another new feature to Maps is Drop Pin. You can use a dropped pin to fine-tune your exact location, maybe to where your car is parked a few blocks away. Tap here to reveal the other Maps features, then tap Drop Pin. A new pin appears marking your location. You can save a dropped pin as a bookmark or use it as the start or endpoint for directions. To fine-tune a dropped pin's location, just tap and hold the pin, then drag it to the new location. Also new to Maps is Hybrid View. To see the Hybrid View, tap here, then tap Hybrid. This combines Map View and Satellite View with street names overlaid on top of satellite imagery. If you have websites that you frequently check, a favorite newspaper, blog, or sports site, why not create an icon on the home screen that will take you directly there? Let's say you like to check the New York Times every morning. Notice the new plus icon. Tapping the plus brings up a new menu where you can add a bookmark, add to home screen, or email someone a link to this website. If you tap add to home screen, you can name the icon, then add the new web clip to your home screen. You can also create a web clip of a specific section or part of a website. Let's make a web clip of the top iPhone web apps. I can zoom into the list by double tapping, then tap the plus, tap add to home screen, name the web clip, then tap add. With this latest software update, it's possible to customize the icons on your home screen. You can arrange the icons however you like, change the icons on the dock, and even have multiple home screen pages. In fact, you can now have up to 9 home screen pages with space for web clips, web apps, and all the third-party applications to come. To customize the arrangement of icons on your home screen, tap and hold any icon for a second or two until you see all the icons start to wiggle. You can then drag any icon to a new location. If you'd like a different icon in the dock, first move one away, then drag a new one in. The dock icons are displayed on every home screen page. To move an icon to a different home screen page, drag the icon to the edge of the screen and slide to the next page. If you want to delete a web clip, just tap the X in the upper left of the icon, then tap Delete to confirm. When you're finished customizing your home screens, press the Home key to lock everything in place. If you have multiple pages, the total number of pages and the position of the currently displayed page will be shown here. To move between home screen pages, just flick left or right. Sometimes it's useful to send multiple people the same SMS text message. For example, you may need to send an update to a handful of your colleagues or a group of your friends. To send a text message to more than one person, Tap the plus in the To field to add additional people from your address book. If you need to add a phone number, tap here to access the numeric keypad. Compose your message, then tap Send. Because iPhone saves a history of your text messages, with one tap, you can send a new message to the same group. Movie rentals have come to iTunes. And like all other video content in your iTunes library, you can transfer and watch rented movies on your iPhone. When your iPhone is connected to iTunes, rented movies show up in the Video tab in the new Rented Movies section. You simply select the movie rentals to sync, then click Apply. On the iPhone, rental movies show up here, so you can tell the difference between purchased and rented content. Movie rentals also have an expiration date, and the time remaining on your rental will show up here. Another new feature is the ability to navigate by chapters. You can now jump forward or backward through a movie using the chapter markers. There are several other features and improvements in this January 2008 software update. Google has added IMAP support to Gmail, which is now integrated into the automatic email setup on the iPhone. If you have song lyrics, iPhone will now display them, and you can purchase music from the iTunes Wi-Fi music store using gift codes. For more information about iPhone, please visit apple.com/iPhone. Thanks.